Firstly, we'd like you to introduce yourself and tell us about your department and the department in which you are helping.
Okay, so I am Amod Zog. I am from the Computer Science Department, BTech. And I am going to help in Computer Science Department, but I am going to work in Biomedical Engineering, a group with Biomedical Engineering.
Could you please share with us some general funde for helping?
Yes, first you need to really decide whether you are going to app or not, if you want to do a job or whether you are going to app. If you are going to app, are you going to do an MS or a PhD? So, once you do decide that you are going to app, do an MS or a PhD. First, if you are going to do a PhD, then you should be really sure that you want to work in that particular field. And that you really want to go deep into that research. If you have any doubts about it, it is better not to commit to a PhD, and it's better to do MS. MS is just for 2 years, you can get a very good job with MS. And if you are getting some kind of an average job in your placements, it is better to do an MS and get a better job, because many people in average universities in India don't get a good job, and they do an MS and they get better jobs than IITians get in their placements. So doing an MS is useful in that respect. Otherwise, the general apping process is, first you have to give some exams like GRE and TOEFL. GRE you can generally give in the third year. For BTECs it is third year, second sem or fourth year, first sem. Third year, second sem is the best, ideal for preparation. TOEFL you can give it any time during fourth year, first sem. It doesn't require much of a preparation if you can converse properly in English. It just requires maybe 1 week if you can't do that. So, that is one thing.
How should I plan my stay at IIT Bombay, and what sort of interns or records should I offer?
So, first of all, you may not really know whether you are going to app or not in your first year, second year, or maybe even in your third and fourth year. So, it is always good to prepare for apping by doing good internships, doing your seminar under a good professor, doing it well, and working well in your BTP. But if you hit this, you can always work in that direction, because that will help you in your placements as well. You don't really need to prepare anything specially for placements. If you are going to app, it is always better to work in to do your internships in some sort of a university or some sort of a research place instead of a company. And the options, you need 3 records in almost all apps. So you have to get those 3 records. The way you can get those 3 records are by working well in your second year internship, in your seminar if the new curriculum does have a seminar, and your third year internship and your BTP per stage. So you have to get 3 records from all these 4 choices. You can also get a course reco if you want, but it may not be as strong as a research reco. So second year internships it is better to do in, you can always go abroad because there is nothing stopping you, stopping any SOFI from doing that. There is no rule. So, but doing it is better to do it in IIT because you get to know a professor and you get to know his researcher. After your second year internship, at the end of the third year first semester, you have to decide your seminar topic. A seminar is basically just a literature survey of different papers, and you need to understand the topic well. For that, you have to choose a professor and work really well under him and impress him to get his reco. You may continue your BTP under him, but that is more advisable because the reco will then be obviously stronger. But even if it's not, then you can get different recos from your seminar guide and your BTP guide. Other than that, CPI. So CPI is important, but not that important. You should have a decent enough CPI, which is greater than 8. So less than 8 may not be completely meaningful. If you have less than 8, it does not really preclude you from any other apps, but still. If you have some average of CPI, say 8 to 9, then you need to work really well in your internships and get good records. Good records are anytime better than CPI. They rank higher than a CPI. and you should generally do your BTP first stage really well, impress your professor, involve him in your applying procedure. So ask him about different universities you are going to app in, and take his opinion, take his help. He will also suggest some professors, some groups. So decide about that. If you are going to do an MS, it is better to do it in a... If it is better to decide the universities based on their general ranking than the research potential in the universities. If you are going to do a PhD, it is better to look out for better groups in the universities than the university rankings. So in a particular university, the group might be really great, but the university ranking may not be that high. So if you are doing a PhD, you should consider the group or the professor. And if you are doing an MS, you should probably consider the university ranking. Apart from that, CGI, GRE, GRE doesn't matter much. You just need a basic score. 1400 plus is more than enough if you have the other stuff. It is just a qualification requirement that you need. And TOEFL, you need to have some cutoff, higher than cutoff score, but that cutoff is pretty low, so almost everyone can clear that.
Okay, which is better, a foreign PTE or a research PTE done in India?
Any meaning, if you are doing a research PTE in India and the prof is very well known, generally well respected in this area, it is obviously good as a foreign internship. In a foreign internship, both are, meaning in the second year, I would rather advise an Indian PTE. But in the third year, there is no, you should generally go to foreign PTEs just to experience how research is carried out over there. And but it is also good to involve yourself in Europe or anything of that sort from the second year. So you can work in a particular research area with a prof for long enough time to let to convince him that you are a good student and you will work. You are good at research. So Europe is also a good option. You don't always need an internship in the second year for doing a project.
Anything else which you would like to share with us to help Janta and Akin?
After you have decided, just do the background work, find out all the universities, find out your groups, find out the professors. Generally the number of universities that you are apping to should be 8 to 10 because apping is expensive. Each app costs around $120 to, you have to send applications, send the transcripts, send the GRE scores, TOEFL scores, so everything costs around $120. So average around 8 to 10 apps is a good idea. After doing that, you should the thing that you should concentrate on is your statement of purpose, that is SOP. Your SOP should be sincere. Your initial SOP, you shouldn't, there are many SOPs on the land which you can read and take funding from, but you should write your own SOP at the first, and you should write all your original thoughts into it, and then let the seniors give feedback on it. The SOPs that you will see floating around on the LAN are extremely corny, and you might possibly think that these are like really stupid SOPs, but you have to add some part of that, but even you need not. You should write your own original SOP, and that really matters a lot if they can see the sincerity through your SOP. So that is one thing. You should generally decide your area of work, maybe one or two. You need not be very specific about it, but you can decide one or two areas of work, write the professor's name in the SOP saying that I am interested in this research and all. So that can help because the professor will contact you in case he needs a PhD student. After that, send your applications on time and before all the deadlines. Do not be in a hurry. Many people make mistakes of writing their SOPs in a hurry and make a mess out of them. Good SOP need not necessarily help, but a bad SOP will definitely kill your chances. Make sure that the last paragraph where you write the university name, you send a SOP for a particular university to that university. If you write, I would like to join Stanford University and send the SOP to Cornell, obviously Cornell is not going to take it. So be careful in writing and correcting your SOPs. Apart from that, you can send mails beforehand to profs you are interested in. That need not always work, but you can always try. And from the 8 to 10 universities, select 2 or 3 which you are definitely sure of getting through. So select them as the backup universities. Make 2 or 3 universities your wish list choices, like MIT or Stanford, which MIT and CS, no one has gone into MIT CS from IIT Bombay CS for some 10 to 12 years, but there's no harm trying to apply. So just put 2 or 3 universities which you really would like to go over there in, and then you can fill up the middle university with other choices that you have.
Thank you very much.